हेलो एवरीवन, वील बिगिन विद द एलिमेंट्री बुक ऑफ एग्रोनॉमी, दैट इज प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ एग्रोनॉमी बाय रिड्डी एंड रिड्डी. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वील स्टार्ट विद चैप्टर नंबर 1, दैट इज इंट्रोडक्शन टू एग्रीकल्चर एंड एग्रोनॉमी.
सो लेट्स बिगिन. एग्रीकल्चर एंड एग्रोनॉमी. एग्रोनॉमी एंड एग्रीकल्चर आर सिनोनिमसली यूज एज दे बोथ आर रिलेटिवली सिमिलर टर्म्स बट येट डिफरेंट. सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट फर्स्ट डेफिनेशंस. सी, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल द टर्म एग्रीकल्चर, इट इज़ डिराइव फ्रॉम द लैटिन वर्ड दैट इज एगर और एग्री, दैट मीन्स सॉइल. एंड द अदर वर्ड इज कल्टिवरा, दैट मीन्स कल्टिवेशन. सो यू मस्ट रिमेंबर दैट द एग्रीकल्चर वर्ड इज बींग डिराइव फ्रॉम द लैटिन वर्ड एंड द अदर वर्ड एग्रोनॉमी हैज़ बीन डिराइव फ्रॉम द ग्रीक वर्ड, दैट विल टॉक लेटर पार्ट. First of all, the agriculture is derived from Latin words agar and cultura, that means soil and cultivation. If you talk about agriculture, it is a broad term comprising of all aspects of crop production, livestock farming, fisheries, forestry. Means agriculture in its right sector, whatever comes in it is agriculture. While agronomy is a specific and a narrow concept, while agriculture is a broad concept. Agronomy is a branch of agriculture which deals with the principles and practices of soil, water and crop management. See, you need to remember this, that it is a principles and practice of soil, water and crop management. Now the most important part is that it is derived from the Greek word agros, that means field, and nomos means to manage. See, this is important because it is recently asked in JRF 2019, I guess, that agronomy is derived from which word, either it is Latin or a Greek word. So you must remember this. After that, there is a definition of agronomy given by Norman. Norman says that agronomy is a science of manipulating the crop environment complex with dual aim of improving agriculture productivity and gaining a due understanding of the process involved. See, if you want to remember this, you can remember, but it is not of much important that it would be asked in the examination. What it would be asked is whether the term agriculture and agronomy are from which derivatives, that is, which one is a Latin and which one is a Greek word. So you must remember these two. After that, these are the basic principles of what agronomy are. Basically, we will be dealing with the soil physical environment, this chemical environment, as well as the aerial environment and the soil biological environment. See, the soil physical environment consists of soil, air, water, temperature. After that, the soil chemical environment consists of soil solution, pH, electrical conductivity, nutrients present in the soil. These are all part of chemical environment, while the biological environment consists of the microorganism in the soil and the reactions responsible for that, like mineralization, immobilization, etc. While the aerial environment consists of the solar radiation, rainfall, temperature, relative humidity and wind velocity. You must go through them once, it is not of much importance. The important part begins from here, that is history of agriculture. It is very important as each year one or two questions would be asked directly from this first chapter, and the most important part of this first chapter is the history. As you must know, whatever subject you are preparing, history is of utmost importance. Either talk of plant pathology, either you talk of any other subject like breeding or genetics. The same is with the agronomy or agriculture too. The history is of much importance. So we'll begin with the ancient period. The ancient period, the earliest man was Homo erectus. See, the first question begins from here, that earliest man is also known as, means his scientific or zoological name is Homo erectus. It has evolved around 1.5 million years ago. See, one thing is important in this only, that what is the zoological name of which man and the year in which they evolved. For example, the earliest man was Homo erectus, and it evolved 1.5 million years ago. Now after that, the other important part is that he moved through old tropics and later to temperate, that is from African region to the temperate region, either to Europe or other parts where temperate part of the continents. Now about 500 years ago, he learned to control using fire. This is of not importance, it is not important. The earliest man request from this also of not much importance. After that, Homo sapiens is the direct ancestor of modern man. See, one thing is important that Homo sapiens is the direct ancestor of modern man. It is not modern man. Modern man is Homo sapiens sapiens. The modern direct ancestor of modern man, that is Homo sapiens, lived 250,000 years ago. And the Homo sapiens sapiens, that is the modern man. See, you must remember that Homo sapiens is the direct ancestor of modern man. And Homo sapiens sapiens is the modern man that appeared in Africa about 35,000 years ago. So I would like to repeat again that you need to only to remember that which the zoological names that, like for example, modern man is known as Homo sapiens sapiens and the year in which they evolved. Like the Homo sapiens sapiens evolved in about 35,000 years ago. The direct ancestor that did Homo sapiens evolved 250,000 years ago. Now after that, the important events that occurred in agriculture. See, important events, though it is mentioned that it is important, but they are never asked. See, like for example, if you read yourself, you will come to know that what is written. The estimated most efficient hunting and gathering can support one person per square kilometer, while pastoral system, pastoral life can support three and other. This is of just the kind of information you will grow through, that what how it evolved for basic understanding. It would not be asked in examination. If you need a basic understanding of this, you can go through this, but it would never be asked. Now, the most important table. See, tables are of very much importance, specifically in case of Reddy and Reddy, as well as in SR Reddy also, that tables are of much importance. See, as the text, as well as tables. Because many a times there the direct questions are being asked in how do we analyze those tables. So tables are of much importance, and this tables I like to discuss. And after that it is very very important that every year one questions would be asked from this part. Like for example, in 2020 only there was a question in JRF agronomy that cultivation of maize started in which year. The answer was 4400 BC. Now there was also a question from this part only, that in which I don't remember the SRF. It was that from this table only. That was the question from this table only. So let's begin that. First of all, domestication. See, domestication of animal began from sheep. Then after that, second the animal that was domesticated was goat. See, the important thing is that the year and what the event that happened in that year. If you talk about the domestication of animals, if there are option given that sheep and goat, so sheep would be the answer that it was the first domesticated. But if there are options like sheep, goat and dog, so this would not be the sequence. The first domesticated animal was dog, after that it was sheep, then it was goat. So you must remember that if dog is given in the option, priority would be given to dog, because dog was first domesticated, followed by sheep, followed by goat. Alright, so if you see that cultivation of crops, the first crops that were cultivated were wheat and barley, and the first animal that was domesticated was sheep. Alright, the year is 7500 BC, then it would be followed with cattle and pigs, cultivation of maize, cultivation of potato, wheels were invented, bronze was used to make tools. Plow was invented in 2900 BC. See, one thing is important, that plow that was invented in 2900 BC, this is a wooden plow, not iron plow, because iron that was used, it was in 1400 BC. It was not of iron. The plow that was used in 2900 BC was not of iron. Those were invented, it was a wooden plow. Alright. Now irrigated farming started in 2900 BC. Silk moss domestication, cultivation of chickpea, this was started in 2300, then domestication of fowl, buffalo, elephant. See, the table looks like it is difficult to remember, but no. In a single day, in a single hour, in a single attempt, you cannot go through this. You can go through this, but you cannot remember it. So if you are a so brilliant student, then it might be possible. But for normal students who cannot, you have to go through this at least twice or thrice, so that you can remember this exactly what it is like. Because many times questions are being asked from this table and it is very confusing. Like for example, if a question is given that cultivation of potato started in, and the options are given like 4400, 3500, 3400, 3000, So we'll be confused that whether it was in 4400 or 3500. So it is very confusing. So you need to go through this twice or thrice at least. Then if we talk about 2200 BC cultivation of rice started, this is very important. Then cultivation of finger millet, then cultivation of sorghum, tamming, and cultivation of sugarcane, irrigation from wells. See, irrigation from wells started in 5500 and irrigation farming started in 2900. See, these are two different things. Now use of iron that began in 1400 BC. And 15th century AD cultivation of sweet oranges, sweet or see these are important other crops that are given that began cultivation in 1600. The table is very important. I would repeat again that one must go through these events very thoroughly so that you can score easily in whenever question is being asked from this part. Now the center of origin of agriculture. See, this is not of much importance until and unless you haven't gone through the crop production part. Means it is basically how the crops were being grown. Like for example, if you talk about sunflower, the sunflower came into India from USSR, that is region about near Russia. Not near Russia, this was a collaboration of certain countries which is dissolved now. It is not, USSR is no longer in existence, but earlier when it was introduced to India, it was from USSR. So you must remember, if you know these things, you do not need to go through all this part that potato, tomato, pepper, when these were developed in South America. And basically these are the, what is given in this part is the crops and from where they were brought or where they originated. So this is of not important if you have gone through the crop production part. If you have not gone through that, you need to go through this. One thing is important that the simplest form of plow that was developed, it is called as ARD. ARD, you need to remember this, because the simplest form of plow is known as ARD, and the important thing is that it was evolved by 3500 BC. While if you talk of the first plow that was invented, it was in, as you can see from the previous table, it was invented in 2900 BC. Alright, so you need to remember that how when plow was invented and when the first plow was used. Now the development of agriculture in India, basically it is important but not from here. This is of not much importance, it would never be asked all this part that is mentioned over here. You need to, if you want to go, you can go through it once, but it is of not much importance. The Middle Ages, the same is the case with Middle Ages too. You need not to go through all this, just skip all this part and directly come to agriculture as a science. See, beside this table, this is the most important part, agriculture as a science, because it involves the various evolution and various contribution of the various scientists in agronomy as well as agriculture. So this is of very, very importance. We'll begin with the scientific agriculture. See, experiments pertaining to plant nutrition in a systemic way were initiated by von Hartmann. So you need to remember this, that experiments pertaining to plant nutrition in a systematic way were initiated by Van Helmont. Now he concluded that main principle of vegetation is water. See, this is important line, the main principle of vegetation is water. It was given by Van Helmont. The other statement that students were confused by is principle of nourishment is water. This statement is given by Francis Bacon. We need to remember this because these are the two confusing statements. Number one, principle of vegetation is water, given by von Helmont, and that principle nourishment for plants is water, it was given by Francis Bacon. The most important other name is zeaxanthin. If you are an agriculture student, you must have gone through this, that zeaxanthin, name of zeaxanthin. Now he conducted several experiments and published a book known as Horse Whying Husbandry. This you might have read through the degree program. And his experiments were mostly on cultural practice, and this is not important. The important thing is that he developed seed drill, horse drawn cultivator. These are the two important things. Zeaxanthin is also known as the father of tillage. Now the other scientist is the Arthur Young. He conducted pod culture experiment to increase the yield of the crops. In certain pods he cultured various crops and The crop that he used was barley, and he published his work in 46 volumes, that is Annals of Agriculture. See, the book that he wrote was not the book, the publishing in which he published was Annals of Agriculture. This is very important because it is asked that who wrote the book or in which publication was Annals of Agriculture, or Annals of Agriculture is related to which scientist. These kind of questions can be asked from this. After that, development of branches of agriculture, that is soil science. Now see, the theory of humus was evolved, formulated in 1809, that is 1809, by Justus von Liebig. While the field experiments were started in Rothamsted Experiment Station, England. This is very important that field experiment was started in which year and at which place. Now the more important thing is the Sir Humphry Davy published a book that is known as Elements of Agricultural Chemistry, and J.B. Laws, he is also responsible for manufacturing of various fertilizers. A truly scientific approach to farming was started in 1840 by Justus von Liebig. This is very important that truly scientific approach to farming was started by whom? The answer is Justus von Liebig, and in which year? 1840. See, the other important thing that student confuses that in 1840, Liebig did not give law of minimum. In 1840, a truly scientific approach to farming was given by Justus von Liebig. Does not confuse it with law of minimum. Now, in 1842, Laws patented a process of treating rock phosphate to produce superphosphate and thus initiate synthetic fertilizer industry. This is important, as I mentioned earlier also, that J.B. Laws began to experiment on the effects of manure on crops, and he also initiated the synthetic fertilizer industry. Now the other important branch of agriculture is plant breeding. See, basically plant breeding history is not given over here, and it is generally asked in the paper, not of breeding part but of genetics part, generally in agronomy as well as in sometimes in soil science also it is being asked. History of plant breeding and genetics, specifically genetics, but if you see over here, only two or three lines are mentioned and they are never asked. They are very important, but it is a basic question, but is never asked. So let's go through it once. Gregor John Mendel, that is popularly known as Mendel, he published his work in 1866. And his publisher book is not given over here, that which book did he publish, and it is important, but though it is not mentioned, so you need not to remember that. Now in 1876, Darwin published the results of experiment cross-fertilization in plants, and the various contribution of Darwin and Mendel, you need to go through the genetics part and plant breeding part, because their contribution and the contribution of other scientists is generally asked in the agronomy GRF as well as SRF paper. Now agricultural engineering, the other allied part of agriculture is agricultural engineering. The mechanism, the important part is that who patented the cast iron chair in 1785? The answer is Robert Ransom. And the first successful tractor was built in US in 1892. And one thing is important, that the most oldest tractor manufacturing company is New Holland. You need to remember this. New Holland is the most, not most, it's the oldest tractor manufacturing company in the world. After that, you need to remember about, this is not of much importance, though you will find the questions related to this in various objective books, but it is not of much importance that application of electricity to agriculture began in which year. It is not of much importance. Now the entomology and plant pathology. The history of plant pathology is not asked in agronomy, but the important thing over given over here is that the first successful large-scale conquest of chemical means was of grapevine powdery mildew, that is caused by Peronospora in Europe. And this is important because it was the first pest that was controlled chemically. the Peronospora, and it causes grapevine powdery mildew. Now the most important line over here is the DDT. It was first synthesized. So it was not first synthesized. It was the chemical properties of DDT was discovered by Paul Muller, but it was synthesized by Ortmann Zindler. We'll discuss it afterwards. Now agricultural economics, it is never asked, don't go through this. Only the important part is that it is not mentioned over here. Yes, it is mentioned, sorry. The key date in the history of agriculture research and education is 1862, because in 1862 it was the first agricultural department was started in the US, not in India. In US it was started, and it's the key date in which agricultural actually started from research and education purpose. Now talking about the scientific agriculture in India, this is very important, though it is not deeply mentioned in Reddy and Reddy. You need to go through this, the scientific agriculture in India, that is history of Indian agriculture through other sources. You need to go through it once. Either you can go through Nimrat Sunda, or also you can go to Arun Katyan. You can also follow Arun Katyan. It is given very nicely in both these books, though it is not mentioned over here properly. But we will go, as it is included in chapter 1, we will go through this. In 1870, a joint department of agriculture, revenue and commerce was established. It is very important that in which year a joint department, see, it is a joint department, that is, it involves agriculture, revenue as well as commerce. While in 1880, first famine commission was established, and after that, the other important part that is given is in 1903, Imperial Agriculture Research Institute was started at Pusa in Bihar, and this gave up a fillip of agriculture research in India. It is 1903, but it is actually 1905. Later in 1912, sugarcane breeding station was established in Coimbatore, and a branch of Imperial Agriculture Research, Pusa, this is not important. The important part is sugarcane breeding institute is located at Coimbatore, and the year of establishment, that is 1912. Now, other important part is Imperial Council of Agricultural Research, that is now known as ICR, Indian Council of Agriculture Research. It was established in 1929. After the earthquake, earlier it was located in Pusa, that is in Bihar. But after that earthquake in 1966, IRI, basically Imperial Agriculture Research Institute, that is IRI, was shifted to from Pusa to Delhi. And the earthquake did not come in 1936, actually the earthquake came in 1934, and the building was shifted to Delhi in 1936. Now the principles of agronomy, it is mentioned that there are various principles like cropping system, tillage, crop establishment, and various other important concepts are being given. If you are the freshers or a noob, you can go through this, but if you have a basic idea about what actually agronomy is, you need not to go through all this. And from examination point of view, it is also not important. If you have a basic idea what agronomy is, it is not important. These are the major events, that is also of not much importance. You need not to go through all this. Now relation of agronomy to other sciences, just go through once through this, need not to remember all these parts. These are of not important. As well as the flowchart, this is not important. There was never be asked. Now the scope of agronomy, this is also not important. See, these are not important. And finally the references, and the chapter number 1 ends over here. So thank you everyone for watching the video. Thank you for watching. Suggestions of any kinds are invited. And if you find the video useful, then you can share it with your juniors, your batchmates, or anyone that you find would the video would be helpful to anyone. You can share it with anyone.